Hello friends, we shall go to the next topic, that is numerical problems on centrifugal pumps now. So before going to that, we shall recapitulate the previous class what we have done now. So we have done how to compute the work done per second when by the centrifugal pump now. So the equation that we derived is W by G into VW2 U2 minus VW1 U1, where W is called as the weight of the liquid, that is equal to rho AV into G, that is equal to W into Q. What is W? Here W is specific weight. W is specific weight of the liquid. Of course, here it is a equal to the water, specific weight of water 9810 is to be taken now. So AV can be replaced by Q now. So it will become WQ by G into VW2 U2 minus VW1 U1. What is VW2? Velocity of the wheel at the outlet. U2 is the tangential velocity at the outlet. VW1 is the velocity of the will at inlet, and U1 is the tangential velocity at the inlet now. So this, if the flow is radial, this VW1 U1 will become zero. Then naturally you will get maximum efficiency when the flow is radial, that is, that will be equal to W by G into VW2 U2. That is what we told now. So however, as a general case, both the things will be there now. Okay. So this Q can be obtained by understanding the width and the breadth of the impeller at the inlet and the outlet. If B1 and D1 are the width and the diameter of the impeller at inlet, and B2 and D2 are the width and diameter at outlet, then the value of Q can be obtained by using formula pi d1 b1 into vf1, pi d2 b2 into vf2. Pi d1, this will become the circumference of the impeller now. B1 is the width, vf is the velocity of flow now. So naturally that will become, this will become a and this will become b. That is what we require, q is equal to a into v now. So work done per second per unit weight, if you take this w will become 1. This W will become 1, then you will become 1 by G into VW2 U2 minus VW1 U1. This we called it as the Euler's momentum equation. Considering the flow to the impeller and the corresponding inlet and outlet velocity triangle, we have further derived the equation V2 square minus V1 squared by 2G. This is the absolute velocity, this is the kinetic energy we called. And this is called as the static energy, U2 square minus U1 square by 2G, VR1 square minus of VR2 square by 2G. It is the kinetic energy that is developed inside the impeller that we called. So like this, we derived the Euler's general momentum equation, general Euler's momentum equation for the centrifugal pump now. Now the next topic that we talked on, the heads of the centrifugal pump. So we classified the head into static head. Static head comprised of the suction head as well as the delivery head. Suction head is from the level of the water in the sump to the center of the impeller, that is called the suction head. And delivery head is the level of the water in the reservoir, that is the where the tank, overhead tank is there, to the center of the impeller. That is the delivery side. This is called as the delivery head now. So monometric head is called as the actual head the pump has to negotiate, where we have to take the losses into account now. That we called it as HFI. So HS plus HD is the actual effective head. HFS plus HFD is the losses, including minor losses in the suction pipe as well as the delivery pipe. So therefore, H static is equal to HS plus HD plus of the losses will give you the actual onometric head or actual head that it has to satisfy, because only if it is designed to this one, the pump will not deliver the water to the overhead tank. Therefore, we have to take the losses into effect. So the various losses also we discussed in the next slides. Now, before that, the total gross head is equal to what? The static head plus the head losses occurring before and after the impeller. So the various losses we discussed are the circulatory flow loss, fluid friction loss, and shock loss and eddy losses. So these are all called the hydraulic losses now. So how it happens, we discuss now. Non-hydraulic losses are the leakage losses and the mechanical losses. How these things will happen is also being discussed in the last class now. Next, we discussed on the efficiencies of the centrifugal pump. The various efficiencies are the manometric efficiency, volumetric efficiency, and the overall efficiency. Manometric efficiency is called as the manometric head divided by the ratio of manometric head to head imparted by the impeller. Now, head imparted by the impeller is nothing but the work done. Work done is equal to W by G into VW to U2 by 1000, assuming that it is radial inflow. Manometric head is nothing but WHM, actually it is being delivered. So using this, we got it as GHM divided by VW to U2 now. Now the volumetric efficiency takes into account the various losses into account now. So actual output which is received in the at the reservoir end divided by the various losses that is also being taken into account, that is Q plus Q. It is the ratio of the quantity liquid discharge per second from the pump, that is nothing but the actual output per second through the impeller, and the quantity passing through per second through the impeller, that comprises of Q plus Q. These losses, what are there, what we discussed in the previous, the leakage loss, the hydraulic loss and non-hydraulic loss will also come into picture. That will be the total discharge that is actually supplied, but because of these losses, only this much of water will be received at the delivery end. So that is called as the volumetric efficiency. The mechanical efficiency takes into account. So as we know, the electric motor is transferring the energy to the impeller shaft to the impeller now. So what is that? The power that is available at the impeller is the output. But what is that we have supplied to the electric motor or the power or the prime mover to the shaft of the electric motor or the prime mover is the power at the shaft. But actual power transferred to the impeller is called the power at the this one impeller. That will be equal to W Q plus Q divided by G into VW to UT. This is nothing but the work done. This is the shaft power. This is what we discussed now. Now the next last overall efficiency, we call it as what is the actual head negotiated, WHM by 1000 divided by the shaft power. What is that we are giving from the electric motor? This is the actual input from the electric motor to the impeller now. But while impeller only, the some losses is going to happen now. So this is the energy that we have transferred, and this is the energy that is coming out. Therefore, WHM divided by 1000, this is called the manometric head now, WHM by 1000, and SP is the shaft power now. So next we discussed on the minimum starting speed of the centrifugal pump. So for starting of the centrifugal pump, minimum power is required. That is, if the power transferred from the impeller, if HP is less than the energy that it transferred from the impeller, then the water will not be transferred. Water will not be transferred to the delivery site. So always the power, that is the head transferring the power, the pressure at the pressure head should always be greater than the manometric head. The pressure head transferred, that is impressed on the impeller should be always greater than the manometric head. If it is not so, If it is not so, we are not going to get the water at the delivery head. That's what we discussed, and with that we derived the equation, that is 120 into eta mono VW2 D2 divided by pi into D2 square minus D1 square. This is the minimum speed the centrifugal has to work so that the pressure developed will be greater than the monometric head, and the pressure head will be greater than the monometric head, and hence the water will be delivered. Otherwise, the rotation will be happening in the pump. That's what we were telling now. Now we will start with the problem now. So the impeller of a centrifugal pump has an external diameter of 450 millimeter and the internal diameter of 200 millimeter, and it runs at 1440 rpm. Assuming constant radial flow through the impeller, 2.5 meter per second, that is Vf1 is equal to Vf2 is equal to 2.5 meter per second. This is what it is given now. You should try to understand. So the impeller as a centrifugal has an external diameter, that is D2 is equal to 450 millimeter, that is equal to 0.45 meter. And the internal diameter is 200 millimeter, that is D1 is equal to 200 millimeter, that is 0.2 meter. And N is equal to 1440 rpm, that is revolutions per minute. Assuming this 2.5, and the vanes at the exit are set back at an angle psi is equal to 25 degree. Find the inlet vane angle, the angle absolute velocity, angle of absolute velocity at the exit it makes with the tangent, that is V2 makes with the tangent, and the net work done. That is what it is being, the work done per Newton of water. This is what it is being asked now. So simple, whenever these things are being asked, you should remember the figure of the velocity triangle. This is the radial input, you know it, this is the radial input, and the input is not radial here now, it is exit here now. This is the absolute velocity, this is the relative velocity. So the component of the absolute velocity V2, horizontal component is VW2, and the vertical component is VF2, and U2 is the velocity, tangential velocity of the vane, or tangential velocity of the impeller at the exit, and VR2 will be the relative velocity now. Okay, VR1 is the relative velocity at the inlet. Now, as the flow is radial, because alpha is equal to 90 degree, VW1 is equal to 0. The velocity of the wheel is equal to 0. That is the general condition that we want to know, unless it is not being given now. So with this background, you remember this, how we solve it usually. When U1 is given, you calculate pi D1 n by 60, that is the U1. So tan theta, you just see the figure now, tan theta is equal to what? Tan theta is equal to Vf1 divided by opposite side by adjacent side, Vf1 divided by U1. So you calculate the value of theta now. So what is, this is the vane angle at inlet now. Okay. Now the angle absolute, well, angle to absolute velocity of water at the exit, that makes with the tan beta, with the tangent, that is this angle beta is to be found now. For finding beta, what you require now? You want tan beta, if you want, Vf2 divided by Vw2 is required. That is Vw2 is required. Vw2 is required. He has given this angle. He has given this angle now. Psi is given now. What is tan psi? Tan psi is equal to U2. Tan psi is equal to opposite side, that is Vf2 divided by U2 minus of Vw2. Vw2. This is nothing but tan psi. He has given the value of psi is equal to 25 degree. He has given now. This is psi now. This is, it is equal to 25 degree he has given. You know Vf2 velocity of flow is 2.5 meter per second and the U2 is calculated just in the previous slide. You can calculate that one anyhow because U2 is equal to pi d2 because he has given you the value of d2 and n. U2 is equal to what? U2 is equal to pi d2 n by 60. Therefore, you can get the value of U2. Therefore, Vw2 is the only answer because tan 25 is known to us. Tan of 25 is known to us now. So, Vf2 is known, U2 is known. You can get the value of Vw2. That is the next step what we are doing now. U2 is equal to, as I have already told you, we have calculated now. U2 minus Vw2, that's what we have written now. U2 minus Vw2 is equal to what you will get? U2 minus of Vw2 is equal to Vf2 divided by tan 25. That is what we are getting now. So you just substitute that equation. So Vw2 is equal to U2 minus of this one you will get now 28.57. Therefore, you will get the value of beta is equal to 5 degree. Okay. So you know this equation now. Therefore, Vw2 is equal to what? Vw2 is equal to Vf2 by tan 5. Vf2 by 33.93 is nothing but U2. U2 minus of Vf2 by tan 5. This I will transfer this one. Vf2 by tan 5. Vf2 is equal to 2.5 meter per second. It is given now. 2.5 meter per second. That is the velocity of flow. It is constant. That is given now. So, Vf2 is given now. Tan 25 is given now, so you can get the value of Vw2 now. When once Vw2 is given, can you calculate this one now? You know Vw2, you know Vf2, Vf2 is equal to 2.5, we know it. Vw2 is equal to, we have calculated now, so tan beta is equal to Vf2 by Vw2, you can get the value of beta. Vf2 by Vw2, Vw2 is 28.57, you can get the value of beta. So, like this, the problem is to be done now. Simple problem now. Okay. And the work done is nothing but what work done per Newton is equal to per Newton he has given. W will become W by G into Vw2 U2. This is a general equation I have written. Vw2 U2 minus of Vw1 U1. This is the general equation. But Vw1 is equal to 0. Therefore, W by G into Vw2 U2 you are having. But per unit he has told this is equal to 1. Therefore, 1 by G into Vw2 U2, Vw2 U2 by G. So, you know Vw2, you have calculated Vw2 28.57. And you have already calculated the value of U2 33.93. Just substitute it. You will get the value of the work done now. So, like this, the problem is to be solved. Nothing much is to be worried. If you understand the concept, if you know the formulas, easily you can supply the formula and get the answers now. A centrifugal pump is working at a speed of 1000 rpm now. This is 1000 rpm now. And this has occurred twice. This problem has occurred twice now. So, it is the outlet vane angle is 45 degrees. The outlet vane angle is 45 degree. This is psi is equal to 45 degree. And the velocity of flow, this is velocity of flow. Velocity of flow at outlet is 2.5 meters per second. That is Vf2 is equal to 2.5 meters per second. The discharge through the pump is 200 liters per second. That is equal to 0.2 meter cube per second now. 0.2 meter cube per second. When the pump is working at a total head of 20 meter, that is HM is equal to 20 meter, the manometric efficiency is 80%, 0.8. Determine the diameter of the impeller. So that is D1 and D2 is to be obtained. And the width of the impeller at outlet, that is B2 is equal to what? That is to be obtained now. So we know, we are already knowing the formula, tan psi is equal to Vf2 divided by U2 minus of Vw2. So this is the equation when the exit is the same triangle we have to remember now. Tan psi is equal to, this is the equation, tan psi is equal to tan psi is equal to Vf2 divided by U2 minus of Vw2. This you can remember. You can remember that equation. So you will get U2 minus Vw2 is equal to the same thing. So you will get the value of Vw2. This is the first equation I am calling now. This is the first equation I am calling now. So also we are having monometric head is equal to G into H mono divided by Vw2 U2. This is what we know it now. So H mono is equal to 20. That is given actual head that it has, that is had, that is the total head he has given. He has not given any losses. Therefore, that you have to take it as H mono. G is known to us. Vw2 U2, we know it. Vw2 U2 is to be obtained now. So Vw2 U2 is equal to 245.25. This is the equation number 2 now. So I know from this equation, I can substitute U2 minus of 2.5 is equal to Vw2. I can substitute here now. That will become what? In this equation, if I substitute U2 minus 2.5 is equal to Vw2. So I can write it as V2 U2 minus 2.5 into this U2 is there now. This U2 is there. That is equal to 245.25 that you will get now. So this will become, if you simplify, what you will get? U2 square minus of 2.5 U2 is equal to 245.25 you will get now. So or you can write U2 square minus 2.5 U2 minus 245.25 is equal to 0. That's what we have written now, this equation. Solve this equation, quadratic equation. You can solve it and you can get the value of U2. These values you will get. This is a positive value. The positive 16.96 you will get, and negative value U2 is equal to negative value is 14.16 you will get now. U2 positive is 16.96, U2 negative is 14.16 you will get now. So positive value we will take now, that will be the U2 now. When once U2 is obtained, you just substitute it into U2 is equal to pi D2 N by 60, get the value of D2. When once D2 is obtained, you can get the value of B2 now. You can get the value of B2 because Q is equal to pi D2 B2 into Vf2. Directly you can obtain it. So with this, I can obtain E1, D1 can also be obtained. If you know pi D1 also know, pi D1 N by N, because U2 will be known to U1 can be obtained and D1 can also be obtained, but it is not asked here now. So let us not worry about it now. So he has asked you only the exit, the width of the impeller at the impeller at the outlet only. Therefore, we have stopped here now. If you want, you can get the value of D1 also from in this problem that may be asked. Try to U1 is equal to pi D because Q is known to us now. So you can obtain the value of D1 because Q is known to us now. Okay. So now the next problem now. So the next problem is a centrifugal pump is having an outer diameter of 2 times the inner diameter. That is, outer diameter D2 is equal to P2 is equal to 2 times D1 now. Inner diameter running at a speed of N is equal to 1000 RPM now. Okay. Works against a total head of 40 meter. HM is equal to 40 meter. The velocity of flow through the impeller is constant. That is, Vf1 is equal to Vf2 is equal to 2.5 meter per second. The vanes are set back at an angle equal to 40 degrees. Psi is equal to 40 degrees. This angle is given to you now. If the outer diameter of the impeller is 500 millimeter, it is not 50, it is 500 millimeter. 500 millimeter. Therefore, it is 0.5 meter now. And the width of water, width of the outlet is 50 millimeter. That is 0.25 meter. That is inner diameter, because inner diameter is equal to 2 times D1. So D1 is equal to D2 by 2, 0.25 you will get. Width at the outlet is 0.05 meter we get. Determine the vane angle at inlet. That is nothing but what theta is to be obtained. Work done by the impeller. Work done by the impeller is equal to what? W by G into VW to U2. This is what you want. Work done by impeller on water per second. Monometric efficiency, that is eta mono, is to be obtained. Eta mono is equal to WHM divided by VW to U2, W by G into VW to UT. That's what you know it. These formulas should immediately come to you now. Then it is easy for you to obtain it now. This figure, the velocity triangle figure, you can very well remember because generally it will not change for a centrifugal pump now. So U1 is known to us. U1 is equal to pi D1 n by 60 because D1 is 0.25, D2 is equal to 0.5. So very well, I can get the value of D1 and D2, and the value of Q can be obtained. Q is equal to pi D2 B2 F2 because he has given you the value of the width at the impeller. This is nothing but B2. B2 is equal to 0.05, you know it. D2 is known to you, 0.5. Therefore, pi into D2 into B2 into VF is given to you. That is 2.5 meter. Therefore, you can get the value of Q now. So, Q you can obtain. This is the first step now. Now, the second step is vane angle theta now. Vane angle theta, how do you obtain? VF1 by U1. This is the equation. Tan theta is equal to VF1 by U1. You know the value of U1. You already calculated pi D1 n by 60. And you know the value of VF1 is constant. You can get it. So that's what we are doing. Tan theta is equal to VF1 by U1. VF1 is equal to 2.5 meter. And U1 you have obtained in the first step. You substitute it. You will get the value of theta now. Okay. So I have already told you how to find the work done now. Work done is equal to W by G into VW to U2. This is what you know it. So how do you obtain now? W into Q by G into VW to U2. So W is 9810 now. Q is equal to 0.1963. This we have calculated. Divided by G into VW to U2. I don't know the value of VW2. We are keeping it like that only. We are obtaining by solving the outlet triangle. What did the outlet triangle says now? Tan psi is equal to VF2 divided by U2 minus VW2. VF2 is equal to 2.5 meter per second. I know it now. And U2, tan psi is equal to what? You just see this triangle. Tan psi is equal to, tan psi is equal to adjacent opposite side divided by this much. What is this? This is equal to U2 minus VW2. U2 minus VW2. You know already U2 now. So you will get one more equation in here because psi is equal to 25 degree. 40 degree has given. He has given 40 degree. This is 40 has given. Tan 40, you know it. So VF2, you know it. VF2 is equal to 2.4. This is no. This you know it now. This is equal to 2.5. U2 minus VW2, you know U2, you know tan 40, you know VF1, only the equation that you will get is in VW2. That's what you will get, the second equation in VW2, solve that, you will get VW2 is equal to 20. That's what tan psi is equal to VF2 divided by U2 minus VW2. So only unknown is VW2, you can get the value of VW2 now. When once VW2 is obtained, substitute it back in this equation for the work done in second. So you will get the work done by the impeller of water per second is given by this equation that you will get. So that is nothing but I am substituting this 23.2 here in this equation. In this equation, that is just look into it. I will read it. That is nothing but 9.9810 into 0.1963 divided by 9.81 into 26.8. In that equation, I am substituting it and I am getting the value of the work done now. When once that is obtained, so I can get the value of eta mono. Eta mono is equal to what? HM divided by W by G into VW into U2. This is what we know it now. So this is the actual head manometric head, that is sufficient. The head that we inputted is equal to W by G into VW2 into U2. So you substitute it in this equation. This G will go up now. G into HM divided by VW2 U2. So you will get the manometric efficiency. Simple problems will be there. Directly you have to substitute and get the answer. Try to remember the formula. You can very well solve it now. Now we shall go to the next problem, which has occurred in December-January 2016. The previous problem has occurred twice now. A centrifugal pump discharges Q is equal to 0.118 meter cube per second now. And the speed is equal to 1450 RPM. Speed is equal to 1450 RPM. And against the head of HM is equal to 25 meter. The impeller diameter and its width at outlet is, the impeller diameter is 250 millimeter, its width, and that is impeller diameter, that is D2, 250 millimeter. 250 millimeter, its width is 50 millimeter, that is B2 is equal to 50 millimeter. Determine the vane angle at the outer periphery. Vane angle at outer periphery, that is beta, is to be obtained for the impeller now. So you know Q, you know this one now. Q is equal to pi D2 B2 into VF2. That we know it now. Pi D2 B2 into VF2. You can get the value of VF2 because you know Q D2 B2. Therefore, you can get the value of VF2 now. Okay, and you know the efficiency, you can get the value of, you know the value of Q, so you can go ahead in that manner now. So just look into here now, these are the data that are given now. So U2 is equal to pi D2 N by 60, U2 can be obtained now, okay. And Q, as I told, you can get the value of VF2 can also be obtained. U2 is obtained. U2 is equal to pi D2 N by 60. VF2 is equal to Q divided by pi D2 B2 now. So when once you know it, you substitute it in the eta mono equation. We have already discussed in the previous problem. So you will get the value of VW2 now. You know the value of VW2. You know the value of VF2. So the velocity triangle. Again and again, I am not putting the same velocity triangle. You try to remember these velocity triangle, then it is possible for you to this one. Tan psi is equal to VF2 divided by U2 minus of VW2. Tan psi is equal to U2, the same equation I have used now. Tan psi is equal to U2 divided by VF2 divided by U2 minus VW2. You will get the value of psi now. Okay. So beta can also be obtained now. He has asked you only what he has asked you in this problem now. He has asked you to find, determine the vane angle. Determine the vane angle at the outer periphery means psi, whereas the absolute angle means absolute velocity with reference to the tangent means beta. So we have to obtain in this the value of psi only. Okay. So beta means it is the angle between the absolute velocity and the tangent. So that also you can obtain because you know VF2, you know the value of U2, you can obtain that one also. There is nothing wrong. You can very well obtain in the next step, even if it is obtained. That is, beta is equal to tan beta is equal to VF2 divided by VW2. That is the equation that we have to use. You know the value of, this is nothing but 17.23, and the value of VF2 is 3. So how I got this? Just look into this. Tan beta is equal to VF2 divided by VW2. Okay. So that equation he has not asked anyhow. So if it is asked, you should be in a position to obtain that also. It is not asked in this problem. Anyhow, can be obtained, that's what I am saying. Now the next problem, the centrifugal pump is running at n is equal to 800 rpm. Immediately you should be in a position to read that one. And working at a total head of 20 meter, that is HM is equal to 20.2 meter. The external diameter of the impeller D2 is equal to 480 millimeter. This is millimeter it should be. And the outlet width is B2 is equal to 60 millimeter. If the vane angle at the outlet, that is psi, is equal to 40 degree and the manometric efficiency is eta mono is equal to 70%, calculate the flow velocity at outlet, that is Vf2 is equal to what? Absolute velocity of the water leaving the vane, V2 is equal to what? Angle made by the absolute velocity at the outlet with the direction of motion, that is beta is equal to what? A rate of flow of pump, that is Q is equal to what? These are the things that he has asked. You should be in a position to write in this manner the various parameters that we want to obtain. Then it is easy for you to solve the problem now. So these things I have written now. So U2, just go as usual, U2 is equal to pi D2 N by 60. You get U2 now. Just get the eta mono he has given now. The value of eta mono is 70% he has given now. So just substitute that G into H mono. The total head is 20.2 meter he has given now. 20.2 meter. Just look into here now. That's what I have written now. H mono is 20.2 meter he has given now. VW2 into U2, you know the value of U2 now, get the value of VW2 now. When once VW2 is known and U2 is known, the outlet velocity triangle can be sought. The outlet velocity triangle can be sought. You know the value of VW2, you know the value of U2 now. So you know the value of this one. Tan phi is equal to, this is 40 degree, okay. Tan 40 is equal to Vf2 divided by U2 minus of Vw2, get the value of Vf2, that is the velocity of flow at outlet, that's what we require now. V2, how do you obtain now? You know, Vw2, we know, Vf2, just apply the Pythagoras theorem, Vw2 square plus Vf2 square is equal to V2 square, you will get the value of V2 now, okay. Now, angle made by the absolute velocity beta, how do you obtain beta now? Beta is equal to Vf2 divided by Vw2. You know Vf2, we know Vw2, just substitute it. Vf2 is known to you, V2, Vw2 is known to you, just substitute it. You will get the value of not beta, it is not theta, it is beta. It is beta now, okay. So just substitute, that you will get the value of beta now, okay. So now, angle made with the absolute velocity at outlet with the direction of the motion, that is beta now. Rate of flow through the pump now, that is Q is equal to pi D2 B2 into Vf2. Just substitute it. You know the value of D2, you know the B2, you know the value of Vf2. Substitute it, you will get the value of Q now. Okay, simple, very simple, solving the velocity triangle now. So this is next problem, 1000 rpm, works against 15, this has occurred in June, July, 15 meter, it is works at 15 meter, has a width of 0.3 meter, breadth of 0.05 meter respectively. The vanes are curved back at 30 degree, this is value of psi is 30 degree, eta mono is 92%, find the discharge, very very simple, find the discharge. So, this type of problem is already being solved, just look into it here. U2 you calculate because you know pi D2, D2 is known, B2 is known. You can get the value of Q also if you want. So U2 is equal to pi D2 N by 60 now. Monometric efficiency, same thing. Get the value of VW2 now. The outlet velocity triangle, tan psi is equal to VF2 divided by U2 minus VW2. Get the value of VF2 and the value of Q. Okay, very simple. Carries 10 marks. Only this much carries 10 marks. Just look into it here, because he has asked only the discharge. Only the discharge is being asked for you. Okay. Now, the next problem is, a centrifugal pump impeller is having an external diameter of 480 mm and internal diameter of 240 mm. External diameter D2 and internal diameter D1 is nothing but 480 and 240 Eh Q1 now. The running at a speed of N is equal to 1000 RPM, not 100 RPM now. 1000 RPM, that should be. The rate of flow through the pump is 0.0576. Q is equal to 0.0576. Okay. And the velocity of flow is constant, equal to 2.4 meter per second. Velocity of flow is constant. That is, VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.4 meter per second now. The diameter of the suction and delivery pipe are, diameter and the suction and delivery pipe are, that is D1 and D2 we can say now. 180, suction is DS. DS is equal to 180 millimeter and delivery pipe DD I call it as 120 millimeter respectively. The suction and delivery heads are 6.2 millimeter absolute and 30.2 meter from water respectively. If the power required to drive is 23.3 kilowatt and outlet is 45 degree, determine the inlet vane angle, overall efficiency of the pump and manometric efficiency of the pump now. So now in this problem, so what is that he has given now? So you know the value of D1. I have substituted all the things. DD I have called, DS I have called, HS is equal to 6.2 meter, HD is equal to 30.2, and power is equal to 23.3, and psi is equal to 45 degree he has given now. 480 millimeter, 240 millimeter, and 100 RPM, discharge is 0.0567 now. So now, you calculate U1 is equal to pi D1 N by 60 now. D1 is known to you now. D1 is equal to 0.24. Internal diameter 0.24. You can get the value of U1. When once U1 is obtained, you can get the value of theta. Tan theta is equal to VF1 by U1 now. This is the inlet velocity triangle. VF1 by U1. So VF1 is constant, VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.4 meter per second. So you can get the first answer, theta is equal to 10.8 degree now. Now, overall efficiency is equal to WQH mono divided by power. That overall efficiency, this is the shaft power. This is nothing but shaft power. What is that he has given now? The shaft power is 23.3. The shaft power is 23.3 kilowatt. That's what it is given. Just look into here now. If the power required to drive the pump is 23.3 kilometer, this is the shaft power he has given now. So you know already the shaft power in this case now. So you will get an equation for eta naught in the form of H mono. I don't know H mono. H mono is equal to, you apply the Bernoulli's equation between the inlet and outlet of the pump. This is the pump I am having. So P1 by W plus P1 squared by 2G plus Z1 is equal to P2 by W plus V2 squared by 2G plus Z2 now. This is at the delivery side. This is at the delivery side. This is at the suction side. This is at the suction side now. So, therefore, what you will get now? What you will what you will get now. So this will become V1 corresponds to Vs, and V2 corresponds to V delivery. Okay, this will correspond to PS, this will correspond to PD now. And Z1 and Z2 will be get cancelled because they are at the same level. They are at the same level, we will assume. So you will get an equation P2 by W is equal to 30.2. That is the HD he has given now. He has given you, just look into here now, 30.2 and 6.2. This is the suction head and this is the delivery head. So P2 by the 30.2 he has given, and this one is also 6.2 he has given, HS. Vs squared by 2G and Vd squared by 2G. These two will be get cancelled. That's what we will write it in the next step now. Vs is equal to Q by A. That is corresponding to Q, you know it already. Q is equal to 0.567 he has given. Just look into here now. He has given 0.0567 Q. Q is equal to 0.0567 he has given. Therefore, you want Vd means Q divided by, have to get pi dd square by 4. This will become the AD. Q by AD will become Vd now. Okay, AD into Vd is equal to Q. Same thing we apply, and you will get the value of Vd and Vs now. Vd and Vs now. Substitute it, this P by W, Vs square by 2G, P by W, Vd square by 2G, I will get H mono. This is the head that it has to, the pump has to negotiate now. Okay. Therefore, I will get this equation. This is nothing but, here we have already substituted eta naught is equal to H mono, 0.02387 H mono is there. I substitute it in the H mono equation, this is 25.03, I will get 59.7% now. So next is, I want to get the eta mono now. How do you get eta mono? Eta mono is equal to G into H mono divided by VW2 U2 now. So U2 is to be obtained, you know, pi D2 into N now. And you want to get the VW2. How do you get VW2? Once again, go to the outlet velocity triangle. That is nothing but VF2 divided by U2 minus of VW2 is equal to tan side. This is the equation that we know it now. So from this you get the value of VW2, because it is at 45 degree, it is given in your exam, in your problem. It is rotation at 45 degree he has given now. Psi is equal to 45 degree he has given now. You've already calculated the U2 now. You have already calculated the U2. U2 is calculated now. VF2 and VF1 are constant, because constant flow he has given now. Constant velocity of flow of 2.4 meter per second. VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.4 meter per second. It is given now. So using this, I can get an expression for VW2. VW2, I can obtain it. So when once VW2 is obtained, I know U2, I know VW2, I know G, I know H mono, we have obtained it, substitute it, I will get the eta mono. Okay, like this we have to solve the problem. So we will stop at this stage today, and we will continue with some more numerical problems, with typical numerical problems in the next class. Thank you very much for today.